Hey guys, welcome to a weird video. Some of you may or may not know, but Grim, one of my mods on Twitch, and my roommate, he's damn near brand spanking new Asus motherboard, the Hybrid CFX, this board. Died on him. Went kaput. Just tits up. Didn't want to do anything. It said, screw you guys, I'm going home. Took all these toys and kicked it out the pram. And quite literally, it died. Not sure if you can see this, but let me move the camera a wee bit closer. The pins, they're not meant to be melted. They're not meant to be brown. That is the CPU 12 volt line going to the motherboard and the CPU. Pretty much this motherboard, okay, this board, okay, came with a combo with the 8-core Black Edition 8000 series CPU. Problem with that is, because it's an 8-core, it needs more than 4 power pins. So, what I'm thinking, and bear in mind, this is what I'm thinking, okay, is the chipset could handle the processor with a BIOS update, etc., etc. However, hardware-wise, it just couldn't supply it. And so, that's what happens. Either the power... That wasn't me, I swear. Either the power supply kind of went tits up, or the motherboard went tits up. Either way, it went tits up. I know that the power pin connector on the power supply is destroyed. It literally almost caught fire. And so, needless to say, this is dead. However, let me get to the point. I'm kind of rambling here. What I've decided to do is turn his loss into YouTube gain. And I think I should make a bodybuilding channel called YouTube Gains. Anyway, long story short, or short story long, however you want to put it, I loaned him my now encoding rig slash was gaming rig. Again, you know, HDMI capture card kind of went, screw you, I don't like working with Intel anymore. Took it out of this rig, put it in the gaming rig, worked fine with the gaming rig, so I figured screw it, swap the graphics cards, because... Just because. Now this has got the 1060 in it and the other one doesn't. And anyway, same dimensions. The motherboards are the same dimensions. And I figured while I have the board and everything out of the old case, which as you guys know is the NZXT Phantom case, the old original Phantom case, I figured, what the hell, let's... One, clean her up. Two, get her ready for some aftermarket water cooling and a few other tad bits. I'm gonna take old things and get rid of them and take some old hardware and try and get it to work and. Yeah, somehow I've got a shoehorn in either this radiator, and by the way, thicker is better, or this radiator. Now, from my personal experiences, now you got to understand, guys, I was water cooling components of, you know, CPUs, GPUs, things like that, when there wasn't water blocks, where you literally would have to take one of the original Intel stock coolers, and you would take the copper cap in the center and pull it out by destroying the actual cooler because it was hollow, and it was the perfect size for 775s. Because yes, I used to have, and I still have, my original 775 system right here. Yes, with the aftermarket X-Brace, I still have my original 775. This is a Core 2 quad, no, Q66. With, I think this has got 4 gigs of RAM on it, 5 gigs. No, it's 1, 2, 3, 4. It did have 8 gigs, it's got 4 gigs now. But the point is, this board is still good, the process is still good, everything's still good. I'm actually thinking about turning this into a little MAME arcade machine thing. So yeah, look forward to seeing that here on YouTube. If you guys like that, give the video a thumbs up and let me know if you're interested in it. And we'll go ahead and make ourselves a MAME arcade machine. Anyway, back to this. So I've got to position out where I want the hard drives, where I want the radiator to be for the perfect airflow and whatnot. Every time I hear crap like that, I picture someone like Hank Hill from King of the Hill, you know? Nobody likes cheese like the Americans, haha. You know, or some shit like that, and I just want to smack someone in the head. And so, what I've decided to do is have mismatched SATA cables for some reason. Is I'm going to be doing some layout stuff. I'll be taking some pictures. Of course, this is my old processor. This is actually going in a different computer. This is actually going to be going into Baroness's PC. So yeah, there we go. She's going to actually get a major bump in cores because she's still using the original tri-core AM3 Plus test processor, question mark, that I got from a reviewer friend of mine. It wasn't even supposed to hit the public market, but AMD said keep it. He didn't have a need for it because he's an Intel guy, and said, hey, here you go, dude, and just gave it to me. And I managed to throw it up on, because he also gave me the motherboard, so I don't even know the motherboard. I know the motherboard brand, it's a MSI, but so yeah, and she's been running 16 gigs of RAM and a tri-core, so needless to say, she's going to be getting bumped up in cores because this is a 6-core. She's getting like a whole shit ton of extra cores over 16 gigs of RAM, and she's going to be getting, I want to say, 960 or a 970. So she's going to get a nice gaming bump up for herself. But she, of course, will be getting a liquid all-in-one cooler. She won't be getting a custom loop, simply because she said she doesn't want to wait. So the custom loop I am building is going to be for the soon-to-be new encoding rig, which will be getting said processor and motherboard from Grim, because he's being bumped up to a Ryzen 5 build. Again, look forward to seeing some content on that on the YouTube channel. We're going to do something similar to Jay's Two Senses Two Idiots build. So we're going to be doing like something very similar to that, just not that format. And so yeah, what I've decided to do is, well, first things first, I've got to strip the rig of everything and then scrub it because it is one dirty girl. And then I'm going to be grabbing the side panels, and because I did a mod already to the case. As you know, the Fantex, the MDXT Fantex didn't come with a side window, so I cut one. And so, yeah, see, I actually cut one. And so what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be getting some plexiglass and plexiing the side here. And yes, we'll probably get some RGB LEDs or something to go in the luxurious computer. I don't want to compartmentalize the thing, which means I don't want like my pump down here or anything else. I'm not sure if I do or not. So this is going to be kind of a little rant video, I haven't got a clue what Cobra is going to do kind of video. And of course, Grim still has my screwdriver set that I thought I'd have ready for this video, so excuse me. Ta-da. Here it is. I have said screwdriver set. This set, when I first got that set from Baroness for my birthday a couple of years ago, it was only like $5 or $6 on eBay. Now that set is going for $30 and change. So yeah, it's always good to get ahead of the game, as they say. Now, this fan I'm unscrewing right now is an old prototype Scythe fan. Again, from my reviewer friend from beyond3d.com. And yeah, this thing's seen better days. I'm gonna do a rebuild on this fan because just for sentimental reasons. But performance-wise, it is outmatched easily by the SP120s. SP120s are my preferred go-to fan of choice for customer builds, simply because they are just a superior fan. They are just a superior, vastly superior fan, and they get the job. I knew it was a long story. And they get the job. Ooh, and I want a chicken dinner. They get the job done. Plain and simple, they do. If you are doing any kind of air calling, water calling, you name it, just bite the bullet and get the SP120s. They're good fans, they PWM, the works. So, yeah, SP120s. No, I am not sponsored by Corsair. I'm not sponsored by anyone. No one ever wants to sponsor me. I'm just a madman who apparently can't find the right screwdriver tip.
Apparently I can't find me tip.
Oh no. Alright. And yes, this is an old this has probably killed more hardware than anything ever. This is an old fan splitter controller thing. It was mostly designed for RGB LEDs, hence the relay. Yeah, this thing had a short out once, and I did a bodge wiring job on it to bridge the issues to bring it back to life, and it works. It works. I don't believe in actual inline splitters like what you get when you buy, because again, when you buy the SP120s, we're going to make the SP120s. When you buy the SP120s, they will have a pin splitter thing. Hey, what's going on? And I don't like those because they put too much strain on the motherboard. They do. Your motherboards are only rated for X amount of amps, micro amps, etc., etc. And so, I just am not a huge fan at all of putting that much kind of strain on hardware. Period. I just don't. And just gonna get my toolbox. I don't like putting that kind of strain on motherboard pin headers, and I'm not the only one. I also believe Jay's Two Cents, and a few other YouTubers, Paul's Hardware, and a few others also hate doing that to motherboard pin headers. Even though, again, with technology, you know, different iterations of chipsets, they just get better and better and better and better and better and better. Giggity, that's what she said. In the end, there's still the actual physical limitations of what the sockets can actually do. And so, I am a big proponent of, you know, external rand splitters. And so, this is probably going to be taken outside and hit with God knows. This thing is dirty. Of course, it's double tied. Why wouldn't it be? Of course it'd be double tied. Who double tied it? Oh, I did. Last time I did any kind of cable management with this case, to this case, etc., was when I first built the rig almost 2 or 3 years ago. So, but as you can see, we've got it stripped now. All we've got is the standoffs, and I'm not worried about them. And so I'm probably going to cut the video here and come back when the case is all nice and clean.